Hi everyone and welcome to Easy Robo Pro. In this video we're going to take a look at Tinkercad 3D design. This is a really easy tool to get you started with mechanical design and prototyping since it's been developed specifically for beginners. Having said that, it shares a lot of features with full-fledged CAD software and will give you a better idea of how to get going with transforming your ideas into actual creations. We'll check out the different tools in Tinkercad and use them to make a coffee mug, which you can customize by the end of this video. Head on to tinkercad.com and sign up if you don't have an account yet. Next, make sure you're on the 3D design tab and click on create new design. This will open up a new project where we will be making the coffee mug design. There are some pre-built shapes on the right, so let's start with the cylinder since it's the base shape we will use for the mug. Change the size to 40. Which will make the cylinder a much smoother shape. Then change the height to 25 and change the base to 22 by 22. Note that these measurements are all in mm. Next, change the color to something that is suitable to you. I have kept it white in this case. Now, as you can see, I am making two copies of that original object. You can use Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V to make copies. One of the copies I'm going to make into a hole and make it a bit smaller. The base profile I'm going to keep it 20 by 20 mm. And the height I'm going to change it to 23 mm. Now just make sure you're raising this hole up till the same level of the original cylinder. So raise it up by 2 mm. Now take the other copy of the cylinder. Make the base 23 by 23. Now to add some custom features to the mug, I'm going to add a label which says coffee around the mug. For this, go to featured shape generators and at the bottom you'll find a customized text option. Now some of the settings in this tool need to be changed so that this fits onto the original cylinder that we have. So first I'm going to change the text to say coffee. You can change this to whatever you feel like. The inner diameter has to be 21. The arc, which is how much the text is curved, should be 270 degrees. And the rest of the settings can be as they are. Now the next part is to align the text as well as the coffee mug so that it looks like it's wrapping around it. So one way to do this is to select both of them by dragging a box around those two objects and then pressing the L key on your keyboard. So what this L key does is that it allows you to align those two objects according to certain parameters. So I'm aligning according to the center of those two objects. That means both of the objects' centers are aligned together. So the centers on X, Y and Z, all three axes are aligned together. Now you can go ahead and group those two objects so that they act as one object. This can be done using Ctrl plus G on the keyboard. Now note that when you group two objects, they might appear the same color. To prevent that from happening, you can go back to color and select multicolor option so that both the colors are retained in the design. Since it's a coffee mug, you need some space to put the liquid in, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the hole that we created earlier and align it at the center of the coffee mug. Select both of them and align these two according to the centers of the base only. Okay, once that is done, we need to take the other cylinder that we created earlier and make another copy of it. So right now this is the fourth cylinder we are working with. Now the copy that we just made has to be incremented in size. You can increase it to any arbitrary size, but I have kept it around 50 mm on all three axes. Change the color to red and keep it transparent. You have an option to keep a color as a transparent color also in Tinkercad. So you can choose that option. The reason being, we need to see what is happening inside this particular object. Now make the original cylinder that we earlier used as a hole and align these two to the center of their bases. So the shape that you get at the end should look like this, and you need to group these two shapes together. So once you select both of these compound objects, you need to align the bases together. Do not align the heights. because the heights are already at where they need to be. Next, make the transparent object into a hole and group it with the coffee mug. So if you notice, what just happened was that the text that we earlier put was very thick and it was sticking out of the coffee mug a lot. Now what this gives us is text that is closely hugging the coffee mug and it seems like it's part of the mug itself and not an extra object that is stuck on the coffee mug. Now the next part will be moving on to the handle of this particular design. So for the handle, I need to go to all shape generators and scroll to page number 8. Right at the bottom, you'll find a pink color object saying extruded curve. So take this curve and change the parameters as per what I have done in this design. Of course, you can customize the design as per what you feel is necessary, but these are the settings that I have used. Since the orientation of the handle was not proper, we need to rotate it so that it faces the cylinder in the right direction. Next, raise it up from the ground to 3 mm above the ground. Now the next part is just about aligning these two objects so that they are facing each other in the right location so that the handle is not stuck at the wrong place. Now after some minor adjustments, I'll be grouping these two objects. So that was a simple coffee mug design in Tinkercad. You can change a lot of parameters in this design, like the font, the colors. I hope you got an idea of how to use Tinkercad and get started with designing your own prototypes. Thanks for watching.